Can you tell how someone looks based only on how they sound? Why, yes, you can. Hey everyone, Laci Green here for DNews. Think of the last time you talked on the phone with someone that you've never met before. What kind of assumptions, if any, did you make about how the person looks based on their voice? A common one would be their sex, which is usually, but not always, obvious. Males with high voices and females with low voices can sometimes cause some confusion. You might even be able to tell their approximate age. Grandmas and children do tend to sound a little different. But what about what their voice says about their height, their weight, maybe even their race? A new study coming out of Washington University and UCLA confirms past studies that people can tell someone's height just by hearing their voice. The participants heard various voices saying meaningless words and then were asked to pick who was tallest, who was shortest, and to rate 5 voices in order of height. Now, the participants were correct 63% of the time, which, okay, admittedly is not extremely accurate, but it's definitely much higher than if they were picking randomly. The researchers also figured out how people were able to accurately guess someone's height. Subglottal resonances. Sounds fancy, no? Subglottal resonances are the sound that come from the lower airways below the Adam's apple, if you have one. They describe it like blowing into a glass bottle. If the bottle's big, there's more room for resonating, and if it's small, there's less room. So the taller you are, the more your voice resonates, and the more your voice resonates, the deeper it sounds. The researchers found that people were able to pick up on very subtle technical differences in these subglottal resonances, which could be particularly useful for busting criminals, because sometimes the only clue about what a person looks like happens over the phone. Another claim that I've heard is that people can tell over the phone how heavy someone is. Could body weight affect these subglottal resonances? Several studies have taken a look and busted the myth. So far, none have found conclusive evidence that gaining or losing weight affects your voice. And what about race? A person's race is sometimes connected to a geographical area, which is then connected to a particular dialect or accent. And in this case, it might be easier to identify someone's race because you know where they're from. But what about when people of different races are from the same area? Then they all have similar speech patterns. Could you tell a Black American from a white American from a Latino American who are all from the same city? Scientists studied this in depth. They looked at how physiology varies by race and discovered that it's an enormous tangled mess, as you might expect when you try to pinpoint physiological differences by something socially constructed. But hey, that's a story for a different day. The takeaway here is that controlling for dialect and accent, there's no evidence that you can tell the race of someone just by talking to them on the phone. Thanks for tuning into DNews, everyone. If you're interested in vocal matters, you should check out Trace's video about why we hate our own voice. And we'll catch you soon with more science updates.